पूर्णिमा मी Tonight's this event, we welcome you all to an expert's talk on AI/ML with our guest and expert, Mr. Rishabh Dhenkawat. In today's session, you all will be introduced to AI/ML by an expert in the stream. At the end, we will also have a Q&A session. For that, you can send me your queries in the chat box. Before moving forward, let me introduce you guys with Mr. Dhenkawat. Dhenkawat is an AI ML developer at Suitable.ai. He has experience in developing cost-effective AI/ML projects for an end user using technologies like artificial intelligence, graphic database, deep learning, machine learning, NLP, computer vision, Neo4j, Docker, C++, differential private ML models, Graph Neutral, Nets, Raspberry Pi. He was the winner of SAT India Hackathon 2020 under AICTE and lost votes talents by Times of India, GitHub, IBM. He is leading a project named Drishti. Drishti is a deep learning project which can control persons like a remote control boat. The main idea of this project is helping building people navigating through obstacles. He has also organized many hackathons with spec and still planning to arrange many more. Without any further delay, I would request Rishabh to enlighten us on AI/ML. Rishabh?
Hello, is my screen visible, Purnima? Okay, I'm sharing.
Your camera is on, but screen is not visible
yet. Is it now?
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
Okay. You may start. Yeah.
Yeah, that's good. Is my presentation mode visible?
Yes, it is.
It's in a full screen. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So first of all, thank you, AT, for inviting me. And first of all, I would like to thank all the organizers and our faculty members, those who are present here. I would like to thank them all for inviting me and giving me this opportunity. Priyanka ma'am and all other faculties. So shall I start? And along with thanks for a wonderful introduction, Purnima. So shall I start the session?
Presentation view is not visible now.
Yeah, I'm sharing that. Okay.
Yeah, good to go.
Is it? So thanks for the Purnima has already given a wonderful introduction of mine. I am Rishabh Dhenkawat. Currently, I am in final year, Computer Science and Engineering Department in National Institute of Technology, Hamirpur. And currently, I am AI/ML developer at Suitable AI and incoming SD intern at Mirafra Technologies. It's a company which is working along with Qualcomm. So first of all, let me make sure few things that it should be an interactive session, and I want you all to write everything. I can. Are the attendees allowed to unmute themselves?
No. They are not allowed.
Okay.
They can send their queries and things in the chat box.
So the queries, and I want an interactive session with you all, So that's why you can write in the chat box, I think. So
yeah, I'll convey all the text to you.
Actually, the chat box is not visible to me. Yeah. Just wait a minute. Okay. Actually, it's a bit difficult side by side for me to see the chat box also.
No worries, take your time.
Okay. Let me share the full screen first.
Chat box is not available for attendees. If you attendees have some questions, then I will be able to revert to me.
Yeah, sure. So, okay, let's start that without further delays. Side by side, I'll use books also. Okay. Ha, yeah, now it's cool. Is my screen visible?
Yes, it is, but in a normal view, not presentation one.
Okay, is it in that view?
I think, no, not yet.
Now is it in the presentation view?
No.
Teams is showing.
Teams is being shown.
Okay, no problem. We will see that chat box side by side.
Okay,
so let's start without wasting any time. So first of all, let me ask you from you all that what is AI to you? Can you turn on the chat for the participants so that they can write in the chat box? Yeah. Please turn on the chat box for the participants. Like, I don't want a thing like from the one side session. Hello, Poornima, please turn on the chat box section.
Yeah, I'm asking. Just a minute.
So guys, there are the few things I want to make sure that you have a copy and pen with you, and the interaction should be side by side, like you can on the chat box. Okay, so yes. It will be interaction session, everything side by side. I will ask the questions also, and you can ask the question in between to me, so that we will have an interaction. Like, there is no koi ek tarike se baat nahi hogi. Okay, so just please turn on the chat for the participants. Aise kya hoga, only like there is like a, it will be like a class only. Yeah.
I'm doing that, just give me a minute.
Actually start the chat box first, because it will not be a compatibility issues will be there if I just actually, the flow is like this, that I have to ask the questions in between.
Actually, we are facing some issue.
Okay. Oh, you are also doing a live stream, na? You can tell them to write on that live stream. Just give me the link. I will take the answers from that live stream.
Sorry?
You guys are also doing live stream, na? On YouTube.
Yes.
They can write in that live stream also. I will take the questions from that stream.
Okay.
Because the thing is, these questions are in, like, there are so many questions in between for them also. Just send me the link of that YouTube.
Hello, Rishabh.
Yes, sir.
Rishabh, we cannot switch on that chat at the moment, right? Because, so you start taking live session. If the question will be there, Poornima and Harsh will inform you later, right? In Q&A session, right?
Okay, sir. Okay, so just send me the live link also. If there are the questions, like, I have to ask that what is AI, like how, like
Poornima,
what is
Poornima will tell you. Poornima and
tell
him live.
Yes. Can they write the answer in that chat box of that YouTube link? Okay, so it's at delay, then we can start only, that like there is a time limit also. So okay, what is AI to you? So if it would be a question that I may have asked you, what is AI to you? So AI se aap log kya samajhte hain? I think jo bhi hai, matlab, what a kind of things you like to ki mean by artificial intelligence. I think chat is still disabled. Okay, no problem. So let me start. What is, so today the things I will be covering is what is AI and when something is AI. So coming to the first question, when AI is a machine, when a machine exhibits artificial intelligence, perceive the environment and take action and make decision to maximize the chance of the goal. Just imagine that you are sitting alone in a room, that what are the things you will learn? Okay, just imagine. Okay, chat box is not still up. So just imagine that if you are sitting in a room, what are the main aapko bol dun ki you have to sit in a room for a particular hour, in 1 hour, in an empty room. There are no stickers or pictures on the wall. Then what are the different things you will notice? You will learn nothing. And just imagine if I will make you sit in a room where a word map will be there. Okay, so what after 1 hour, what you will get to know? You will get to know the exact points and the longitude, latitudes, and what are the different countries and capital of that particular map when you will come out of that room. Okay, so these are the, so just imagine, like, as you know, as your brain worked in an empty room and in a room filled with a word map and different kinds of photos, same is with the AI. The more data you will give to a machine, or the more teachable you will make the machine, the more accurate you will get the results. Okay, so this is something when AI is made compatible with the machine. Okay, so yeah, YouTube link is with me. Yeah, so yeah guys, you can write the responses in the YouTube link. Harshav shared to me. I will be asking some questions in between to make it more interactive, and we can interact like there is not be a one-to-one session. So okay, all you are up in the live chat, also in the YouTube live chat, just send me hi there if you are all active on that live chat also. Yeah, just send me a hi. Okay, I'm continuing. Okay, so AI is something when a machine exhibits intelligence, perceive the environment, take action and maximize chances of a goal. Okay, so these are the particular movies. Acha, isme se kaun kaun si movie kis kis ki favorite hai, just write in that chat box of that YouTube link. Okay, yeah, so kis kis ne kaun kaun si movies dekh rakhi hain? These are very old movies, like you see 1927, 1968, 1983, 1982. Kis kis ko isme se kaun kaun si movies kis kis ki favorite hai? Okay, so like one of my favorite movies, Matrix, the Matrix, and it will be a kind of movie which is based on AI. So hum kya karte hain? Basically, when we are the young students, when we are in times of our childhood, we used to grab the things and we used to set our career as per the movies only, like our superheroes and all that. So these are all the particular movies which have exhibited the example of AI. Okay, artificial intelligence in real world. So the thing is, after 10, these movies are written in like 1999, 1984. But just imagine the scenario after 100 years. These will be the real scenario after that. So you should also take care of that also. Okay, yeah, like Aditi is writing Blade Runner, Terminator, Matrix and Terminator. Yeah, definitely. Jisne ek bhi nahi dekhi. Okay, SS. ये पढ़ने वाले बच्चे हैं. ओके, सो लेट मी टेल यू व्हाट इज कॉग्निटिव कंप्यूटिंग. सो दिस इज अ पर्टिकुलर वर्ड. देखो, ऐसा होता है, वी ऑल हैव हर्ड अबाउट आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस एंड ऑल दैट. सो देयर इज आल्सो वन टर्म व्हिच ऑलवेज कंबाइंड विद आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस, कॉग्निटिव कंप्यूटिंग. दीज आर द पर्टिकुलर टर्म्स व्हिच आई एम यूजिंग इज एज पर द डिफरेंट, लाइक वी गो इन डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ इंटरव्यूज एंड ऑल दैट, एंड दीज आर द बेसिक क्वेश्चन. लाइक जो भी पूरा सेशन रहेगा ना, उसमें बेसिकली बिफोर एज पर द रिसर्च एस्पेक्ट एंड एज पर द इंडस्ट्रियल एस्पेक्ट, बोथ पॉइंट्स आई विल बी कवर. सो अगर artificial, if you are knowing about the artificial intelligence, you should know about the cognitive computing too. So you see, there are the two pictures I have shown to you. One is artificial intelligence, the second is cognitive computing. So although cognitive computer ke bare mein koi zyada baat nahi karta hai, but if we go in terms of our syllabus and all that, cognitive computing is like similar to AI. So this is the first thing which we need to separate these two things. What, somewhere they are also overlapping. So for example, this is a particular person which is standing. So what artificial intelligence will give to that person? You see what I have written. It will assess the skills. It will use the AI and it will give them the relevant job after using some particular algorithms. And what is cognitive computing? It is a kind of database. Okay. Prediction is somewhere less in the cognitive between. Okay, let's dive into more. So just take a note of these two things: cognitive computing, artificial intelligence. If you I heard that you, most of the guys are from the first year, So the thing is, you should know about the basic difference of these two before diving into the artificial intelligence. So that in future, if someone will ask that what are the difference between these two, then you may don't confuse between these two. Okay. So these are the things. Up cognitive computing mein kya hota hai, ability of computer to simulate complements human cognitive ability of decision making. Okay. And what artificial intelligence, they use some kind of training algorithm. So you just see this point. Just focus on these two points. Not responsible on making decision for human. Responsible making decision at their own. So these are the basic two differences between cognitive computing and artificial intelligence. So you see, कभी कभी क्या है बहुत confusion आती है कि artificial intelligence क्या है and different जो the same thing we can do is without using artificial intelligence also. Okay. तो ये चीज़ अभी सबको clear हुई ना एक बार yes लिख दो. और अगर किसी को कोई bore लग रहा हो किसी को कुछ भी सेशन में अगर मजा ना आ रहा हो तो वो कर लिख सकते हैं चैट बॉक्स में. ओके ओके सो दीज थिंग्स आर क्लियर ना. ओके तो अगर कोई डाउट है तो वो हम 1-to-1 सेशन में बाद में पूछ ही सकते हैं. ओके सो नेक्स्ट इज नाउ लेट्स फाइनली डाइव इनटू आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस. फर्स्ट लाइव डाइव. अच्छा ये क्या हो रहा है ये कोई बताएगा ये कौन सी चीज है इसको क्या कहते हैं कौन सा डिटेक्शन है क्या है ये क्या है कोई बताएगा. आयुष जैन ओके गुड. क्या क्या कहते हैं इस चीज को जो अभी ये स्क्रीन पे चल रही है ये GIF पता. या डेफिनेटली फेस डिटेक्शन. अच्छा ये फेस डिटेक्शन है फेस रिकॉग्निशन है इसमें भी बहुत बड़ा कंफ्यूजन होता है. ओके ये फेस डिटेक्शन है या फेस रिकॉग्निशन है द नॉर्मल इंग्लिश टर्म्स आर देयर. ओके या फेस रिकॉग्निशन इज देयर देयर इज नॉट फेस डिटेक्शन. फेस डिटेक्शन तो हो रही है साथ में फेस रिकॉग्निशन भी हो रही है. ओके तो एंड में हम फेस डिटेक्शन करने वाले हैं. ओके So what is AI? Let's finally dive into the definition of AI. Okay, so now let's talk what is AI. So AI is application of state of art, statistics, machine learning, robotics to deliver prediction, automation or augmentation tools. Dekho, aisa hai, whenever you talk to someone that what you grabbed from this session and what is artificial intelligence to you, aapka koi chota bhai bhan aapse puche, to agar 11th, 12th ka ho ya 10th ka ho, to phir kya kehte hai, this is the particular definition which you can tell to them. Okay. What is AI? AI is application of state of art, statics, machine learning and robotics. So, ab prediction kya hoti hai? Prediction, so basically these are the different terms which we regularly use in for artificial intelligence. Prediction, fraud detection, automation, augmentation. So, prediction we all have seen, we all are using that thing, Google Voice Assistant, that is predicting that what are the different next question you will ask, that is prediction. What is automation? Like you see, you go on Netflix and it will automatically predict you the next movies which you should watch. So that is called automation. Okay. So abhi tak kisi ko kuch complicated to nahi lag raha hai na. Agar kuch bhi complicated lag raha hai, you can write thing. Okay. Agar beech mein let's more, make it more interactive and more fun. Okay. So now let's dive into the next. Okay. So creating an AI required. So what do you understand by the algorithm? Like just write out one or two lines in the chat box. What do you understand by algorithms? Like you help from postulates and algorithm, that was a chapter in our 10th class. So you may have heard about that algorithms in that 10th class only. So you know what is algorithm. Okay, no problem. So algorithm is a particular step by step of making some task possible. Okay, 10th class mein you all are in first year of college and we all have heard about algorithms in first 10th class. Postulate, there was a chapter in NCERT, postulate and algorithms. Okay, so step by step of making something possible is algorithm. So college mein aane ke baad kya hai, bacche darte hain ki kya kehte hain, though like there are the different terms, how we will grab the thing. So that is not a very big thing. Jo aap 11th 12th padh ke aaye ho, jo maths you have learned in 11th and 10th 11th 12th class, that is the same thing. These are the that AI is just a modified version of those things. I will come to in coming slides. So ab koi bhi main ek AI banane ki baat kar raha hu, jaise na algorithm hai, document hai, ground truth hai, theek hai. Ab main I took the exam basic steps of doing a program, right? Great. ओके सो अब मैंने आप लोगों को क्या बताया कि रूम का मैंने आपको एग्जांपल दिया. अब मैंने आपको रूम में बिठाया. ओके दैट वाज एन एल्गोरिदम. ठीक है मैंने आपको मैप दिया दैट जस्ट लिसन दिस केयरफुली आई हैव गिवन यू द मैप दैट वाज अ डॉक्यूमेंट. ओके ग्राउंड ट्रूथ क्या होगा, मैं आपको एक स्लिप और दे दूं कि भाई आप अपने आप को टेस्ट करो कि आपने जो आपने जो कंट्री की कैपिटल का नाम पढ़ा है दैट इज ट्रू और नॉट. अगर आप अपने आप को टेस्ट करो दैट इज ग्राउंड ट्रूथ एंड एनोटेशन. टीचिंग क्या हुआ, आपके माइंड ने जो आपको सिखाया वहां बैठ के, आप उस रूम में अगर एक घंटा बैठे हो, आपने मैप पढ़ा है, आपने एक पर्टिकुलर वर्ड की कैपिटल का नाम आपने पढ़ा है, दैट इज टीचिंग. और अगर आपने उसको बार बार देखा उसी मैप को, दैट इज आइट्रेशन एंड रिपीट. तो दिस इज द बेसिक डेफिनेशन यू कैन थिंक अबाउट ए आई. जस्ट सिट इन, अगर कोई भी कभी भी आपसे कोई ये चीज पूछे, कोई टीचर पूछता है, यू गो इन फॉर इंटरव्यू, जस्ट जस्ट गिव मी द इंफॉर्मेशन ऑफ ए आई इन द मोस्ट सिंपल वर्ड. जस्ट गिव द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दिस रूम. ओके, यू मे हैव हर्ड अबाउट दैट, यू विल करंटली नॉट नाउ, यू मे हैव हर्ड अबाउट दैट देर आर द टू ग्रेट पर्सनैलिटी लाइक एंड्रयू एनजी एंड एंड्रेज कार्पेथी. वन ऑफ देयर सेशन दे गिव अस द एग्जाम्पल, दे गेव दिस एग्जाम्पल ओनली. जस्ट सिट इन वन रूम एंड sit in an empty room, sit in a room where you are having data. So same jo algorithm aapka brain perceive karega, same thing we teach a computer to do. We give them the documents, we give them the ground truth, okay, we teach them and we iterate them, then we repeat them. Okay, so itna clear hua hai na sabko, koi abhi tak koi aisi parshani to nahi hai na, jyada complications honi nahi chahiye. Okay, so I think everything is going good with everyone. Just write yes in the chat box. Okay. Okay. Yeah. So great. So okay. So this is the particular GIF, which is simple GIF. इसमें इतना complications की ज़रूरत नहीं है. मैं basic से समझाऊँगा. तो अब क्या है, मैंने जो data set दिया था, मैं अगर basic है, you guys are in first year, I will take the most basic example of that room only. Okay. You need to prepare the data. AI में सबसे पहले step क्या करना होता है आपको. अब मैंने starting में कहा है, AI is what when you are teaching a machine. Now your computer is your machine and what you need to do is you need to teach that machine. Okay, so for teaching that machine, what you will do? You will prepare the data. Agar, for example, let's take a kaun si achhi cheez banani hai aapko. Jaise ki, for example, main aapko bolun, aapko bhai computer ko apne aapko face recognition karna hi sikhana hai. Though the face unlock thing that you, the face ID is a separate thing. Face recognition module, which you see in Samsung phones and Realme MI phones, like you show your face and it just get unlocked. So what that thing is happening, so what they are doing, if you will prepare that that software, that what you will do, first you will prepare your data. Okay, prepare your data. What will be your data in that face recognition? What will be the data? Just write in the chat box what will be that data. Okay, what will be that data if you will make a face recognition module? Okay, pictures of a person, yeah, definitely, yeah, you will show your picture. So whenever you train that module, you show your images. Okay, so face pictures, that will be my data. What we have learned till class 8, what we have used to do in class 8, computer only learns about zeros and ones. So this is not the case that you are directly showing the face images, or the you need to prepare according to that machine. Okay, so what will be that machine will learn? It will be like 0 and 1. So binary and numeric format is always interpreted by the computer, and that the same thing we always use in machine learning. Okay, so preparing the data means making the data usable by the understandable by the computer machine. Okay, after that you will build your model. Like there is a Jupyter notebook, VS Code, these are the different basic editors. I heard that you already did Python, so you may did Python in VS Code or Jupyter notebook. Which IDE you have used? IDE, compiler, any scripter you may have used for Python, like Google Colab and different things. Okay, Jupyter notebook. So these are the things you will build your model. Okay, so after that, what the step is, you will train and test your model, that how much accurate my model is. Okay, after that, register and manage your model means, here registering and managing the model is making it more accurate and accurate. Okay, and just making it pass by a different set of parameters. After that, you build an image, you deploy the service. Building image, that is not that building image, that is picture thing means. Okay, building image here is like deploying the things. Deploy, just take the literal meaning of English of deployment. Whenever you make something, like for example, you are in first year, you make a face recognition model. That is not the thing that you will take that face recognition software in your PC only. You will show it, you will give to the particular user, na? Okay, user in means your friend, your person, your family related, that yeah, I have made this software. So you need to deploy that on the server. Okay, so this is the full cycle. You need to deploy this. So deploying means give it, making it ready for a particular end user. End user here is to distribute that software. Okay, to make it trainable. Okay, is it understandable by all? Na? Training and model building image and deploying service. So just take note of these terms. If you are not getting these things, then you can search on the net in future also. So everything is going good. Okay, great. So knowledge and accuracy. So teaching, so making ML model accurate is the most important thing now. Okay, if you are using it for an end user, for example, if you are making something like X-ray image detector, like finding a fracture in an X-ray image, so that should be accurate thing because it will impact a person's life. Okay, so accuracy is more and more important in machine learning. Okay. So artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning, इनके बारे में कुछ पता है? Do you know anything about these things? Artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning. Okay. So anyone know about machine learning or deep learning? How many of you heard that term? Just write yes or no. If you guys have heard about these terms, machine learning and deep learning, in past. Okay. Yeah. Like my audience is really experience with all these things. So one thing I want to make you clear that artificial is not a like futuristic thing, that is a trending thing. Its foundation was around 1950s. Artificial intelligence was done in 1950s only. I will come to how the history of artificial intelligence was there. So what was happened is in 1950s the term artificial intelligence was introduced. Now the subset of artificial intelligence, which is machine learning, that was introduced. Okay. So the deep learning, what is deep learning, is the enhanced part of machine learning. Okay, I will come to these terms in between. Okay, so this is the basic difference between machine learning. If you are sitting, just take the screenshot of this slide. This is the very simplest and the clear way of taking the difference between machine learning and deep learning. Okay, so whenever you talk to someone, they will definitely ask you that what is machine learning and what is the difference between machine learning and deep learning. Or how many know the difference between machine learning and deep learning? Just write yes or no. If you don't know anything, no problem. I will make you clear everything. Just tell me that how many of you know about machine learning and deep learning. Okay, no problem, Adarsh. Okay, Suraj, no, okay. How many else? Okay, yeah, yes, no. Okay, no problem. Ab main batata hu, what, let me tell you what is machine learning and deep learning. So just take example of that tree. I need to make a software, simple software I need to make, where I need to take the image of a particular tree and a car. Okay, now I need to make a software where I want to tell you whether it is a tree or it is a car. Okay, no problem, just focus here. Okay, I have taken an image of a tree and a car. I need to make a software which will detect that whether it is a car or it is a tree. So what machine learning do? Okay, these are the subset of artificial intelligence that I have already told you. Point number one, machine learning and deep learning are the subset of artificial intelligence. Okay, so now what machine learning will do? Machine learning first will extract the features. It will extract what will the features of a tree. Just imagine, what will the features of a tree? It is having a stem. It should be in green color. It should have leaves. It should have branches. These are the feature extraction. Okay. Now, what machine learning, first of all, it will extract the features, and after a classification model will be set up. Classification algorithm. I have told you about algorithm, step by step procedure. Classification algorithm will be made. Okay. After the classification algorithm is made, we will train our model. Like train, I have already told you the word about train. Training means it will give the output of a tree. First, I grab the features. Here I have to make two separate algorithms. Okay, one is for classification and second is for feature extraction. Algorithm number one, I have to extract the features. After those features, I have to give it to my classification. Okay, classification, just take the literal meaning of that classification. Okay, two algorithms I have made. So this is machine learning. Okay, now what network only? Neural network is maybe a new term to you. Now all these things will happen in a new into a simple flow and a simple neural network only. It will automatically extract the feature and classify them. Like there is no need of separate algorithm for feature extraction. Okay, is it clear to you? I think it's not getting out of your head. Okay, just write yes or no if you get the basic difference between machine learning and deep learning, so that we can move forward. Like there are so many contents I have prepared for you guys. Okay, just write yes or no. In machine learning, what we do, we use two algorithms. First is for feature extraction. Yeah, basic idea is clear, definitely. Okay, let me repeat. If you guys are having problem, you can take the recording also in between. Like in machine learning, I have to write the two processes. Like for I have to take the green trees, take the color features and all that. And second, I have to do the classification of those. After that, we need to give the output. And what deep learning is, deep learning in a single flow, in a single neural network, it will automatically take the feature and classify. How this deep learning, is working, I will come to that also. Like basic deep learning perceptron model we will make in somehow. Okay. So this is the particular basic deep learning. Just tell me, this is deep learning or machine learning algorithm? Just tell me, this should be machine learning or deep learning? Like here I am using one algorithm only. Okay, this is deep learning. Okay, because this is already, the feature extraction is already done. Like there is a no separate algorithm is for feature extraction. So yeah, so slowly I will be coming to move and things will be more clear to you. Yeah, Goku, you are right. This is deep learning. Okay, so this is a particular priority, like safety, compliance in healthcare, as I told you about already about accuracy. Most of the artificial intelligence application are emerging in healthcare. Okay. After that, insurance and fintech sector is also using artificial intelligence day by day more and more. Okay, and after that, e-commerce sites. Okay, so these are the different things. These are different sectors. You can take note of that. Okay, so these are the different things. Okay, so goal is saving time. So the main goal of or everything, like computer, everything, the main goal of our this life is also a saving time, so that we can explore more and more and we can contribute the development of our nation more and more. So fine, actual aim is saving time. Okay, so now let me come to the godfather. As I already told you, it's not a new term. Okay, do you know him? Do you know this guy who is known as the father of artificial intelligence? We all know about artificial intelligence. We see on LinkedIn, Google, Facebook, like there is a very, very fancy term. But you know who is the actual inventor? Like you know about Charles Babbage, okay? Who is the father of computer? So you should know about the father of artificial intelligence also. Okay, Owen McCarthy. He was the father of artificial intelligence. Okay, in 1956, you see, we got independence in 1947. Just prior to that, 9 years later, the term first artificial intelligence term was introduced. Okay, so he was the father of AI. Just take note of that. Okay, these are the small things which make you separate from the crowd. Okay, next, Alan Turing. Acha, who know about this guy, Alan Turing? Mathematics, biologist, computer science. Like he is a all-in-one personality. Who you know? Okay, so you heard, you have seen the movie Turing Machine, Alan Turing. Like the Enigma machine. Okay, Adarsh, right? Enigma machine. Just watch that movie. It's a beauty. Okay, so everything comes to artificial intelligence, not that like a fancy term, artificial intelligence. It's all about mathematics and computations. The more you know, the more you are good in mathematics, the more logical you are, the more great and more powerful you will be in machine learning. So he was a mathematician. So the foundation of computer science programming language was maths only. Okay, so what first Turing machine, which was the very basic Turing machine, was created by him, and that is also before 1950. I not actually remember the year, but that was before 1956. And you know, there is a subject like compiler design and theory of computation, which you will read in second or third year. Okay, which you will read in second and third year, and there you make a Turing machine using your notebook and copy and pen. So that was the very basic thing. That was a very good subject that you should focus on. So like audience will be from the CSE branch. So there is the subjects of CSE like database management system. Like there are the very basic subject that you all should know about, and you should focus on your studies because you will be the future of this nation. So you should focus on your subject, because in college the syllabus of every college is very good, and in first year your college is conducting these kinds of session, and that is a really good thing. Okay, I belong to a government college. Like these things are not very much popular. Like we always learn from our ourselves only. Okay, so like so this was the Alan Turing. He was one of the founder of programming language. Just note that movie, like this Enigma machine. Okay. that was a German code he cracked. Okay, so this is a cancer burden that was a Serban Sara in Africa, that was a risk and getting cancer. So this was the one of the good model which was good application which was done in Africa by AIML. So okay, AI action for circuit like AI in healthcare sector, AI is very much important and it helps the doctor to make the decision better. Like and we all have passed through the COVID waves, so that is also very important thing that you guys should know about these artificial intelligence. Instead of just going through the typical placement and all that subject, you should contribute using your mind and these things. You should contribute in your nation too. Okay. So like some of the examples of AI and cognitive computing. Okay, so what artificial intelligence system need, like what is the AI perceive in their environment, what action need to make some chance of success role. So these are the particular questions that you should ask before making any software. So before doing anything, you should focus that what is your goal and how it should critically analyze everything. So our developer response, our particular computer scientists and developers should responsible to make everything accurate for his end user and for this society. So these are the particular questions that you should analyze before making any model. So this is the particular story, like 1997 chess IBM, there was a game between artificial intelligence and a particular person, and artificial intelligence won that game in 1997. And 2016 there was a Go Google game. Okay, so these are the simple action decision and perception. These are the different terms they used, Google and IBM. These guys conducted the games between the artificial. You may have heard that artificial intelligence computer playing chess with a particular person, okay, and all that. So you may have developed a quiz show, understanding human sheep. Oh, so human speech, like you may have heard of voice recognition, voice unlock. So these are the examples. Examples are everywhere of artificial intelligence. Examples are everywhere. So I think there is no need to talk about the very much examples. Okay, Tesla car. This is like Tesla car. So how many think that Tesla car will work in India? That the first autonomous driving car in India. How many of you think that it will work in India? Okay, I'm waiting for the answers. How many of you think? Okay, are you saying it will? I also don't think that autonomous car will work in India, because you know our Indian roads. Even the autonomous car, if I have studied the proper documentation of autonomous car, even in US only, there are some particular roads which this car is working on autonomous mode. Okay. So there is a story that Elon Musk thought that it is prone to hacking. So they have made one feature that if the car gets out of control, there is a particular button in this car so that you can cut all the connections with the server so that no one can hack your car. So the companies Tesla like also caring about the different aspects, that how that care, that take care of that particular driver. So as a student, that we should also think about, if we are writing any research paper, we are going into an industry, that how my end user will perceive the software. Okay. It is difficult in India. So like image recognition is going good in India. Okay. Image recognition is very much accurate in this thing. And I will come to that image recognition, sound recognition, also analyzing text. So like there is so much theory. Now let's dive into directly into that. Object or optical character recognition. These are the, have you heard about optical character recognition? Yeah, these are the like Microsoft Alexa chatbots. These are all working examples. But you see, the basic principle of these, everything is basic maths only. Okay, so these are the everything you can make on your own only. So being a student of engineering, so you should not say wow or just excited with these kind of technology. They are also using very basic principles. Okay, so in at this stage also you can do these kinds of thing only. Okay, this is the particular machine learning. Like machine learning, I have already told you about machine learning, like feature extraction and everything. So machine learning is, just take note of these three things. Machine learning is divided into three categories: supervised, unsupervised, reinforcement learning. So unsupervised learning kya hoti hai? For example, you are learning from YouTube without any help of a teacher, like you guys do in exams. Okay, but you should take focus of the teacher notes also. Okay, so if you are getting yourself prepared for exams using the teacher and taking everything from by the teacher only, then it is supervised learning, because you are learning something under the supervision of some person. And what is unsupervised learning? Unsupervised learning is you are learning your own. You are perceiving the environment. I make you sit in a room. Okay. And next is reinforcement learning. Reinforcement learning in the sense is you are learning from your mistakes. Okay. Learning from your mistakes. So these are the three basic techniques in reinforcement, unsupervised and supervised learning. So these are the different, I will share this PPT with Harsh. So these are different algorithms which are like classification, regression, dynamic clustering. These are the different terms which we use in supervised learning, unsupervised learning and reinforcement learning. So currently we are not diving into these so much deep, because these things will clear if you take a particular course and take 1 or 2 hours and learn with yourself, because so that will be a much great thing. Okay. So these are the particular basic things. Of machine learning. Okay. So let's come to maths. Okay. This is the very simple maths. No need to fear. So this is the basic particular maths. I just want to make you clear that artificial is not a very big thing which you cannot learn. Even you can learn artificial intelligence using copy and pen only. Okay. These are the basic algorithms. So what is this y is equal to mx plus c? What is y? How many have you prepared for GE? How many of you prepared for GE? Yeah, straight line equation. Yeah, definitely. So in 11, 12, we all prepare for our GE exam. So there is a very good maths like we used to learn in straight line. Okay. So do you think, okay, now let me make you a basic example using this straight line. Okay. So this is the very basic thing which we use straight line. So that is regression. I told you about this thing, regression. Regression here is just a linear regression. So you see, I teach my model using this linear regression only. Like what I need to do is if I make a face recognition model. So just focus on this y is equal to mx plus c. You see, this x can be my input image and this y can be my output image. So I want to check whether it is belong to my image and whether it is not belong to my image. Okay. So this is my input and this will be my output. And this is my particular parameters which I am training. So you see, training here means M and C, you are training, and using these trained parameters, you are predicting y. So this is a very basic example of, you can perceive the very basic example of artificial intelligence. Okay. This is the basic thing is clear. Just take example, x is your input image and y is your output image. Okay, so you are making a straight line using this. So when you have fixed parameters of M and C, you can get the output. Okay, and this is a live example, like using linear regression, you can teach a face recognition model. So let me come to the neural network. So that is, though, don't get fear of using this word neural network. That is the part of deep learning. So you all have heard about metrics in your first year also and your 11th and 12th years also. Have you heard about metrics in your 11th, 12th? Yeah, we all have. So basically deep learning is nothing. It's a just multiplication of metrics, tensors, you know, metrics and tensors and high dimensional metrics, low dimensional metrics, rank you have. I think the engineering mathematics, if you are having subject in your first year, you may have this subject as your rank also, matrix rank, what is matrix multiplication. So you see, this is the basic aim of this neural network, na, is that I have already shown you in this previous slide, like this. These are the very complex neural network. That is nothing but that is this matrix. Okay. We are just multiplying the matrix here. Okay, I will come to now. I will make it clear that how these matrix multiplication are training a particular. We are using this matrix for training a particular model. Okay, so I think session is going good. If you yes, you can write yes or no. Yeah, I think if I am able to make things clear to you. Okay, then we, if you are having doubt, we will cover in coming session. Also, like I am having a good examples also for you. Okay, where is this? Yeah, I will come to that only. Okay, so I think Harsh, can you tell me how much time we have left? I think we can go for some basic maths also or not.
We have around 30 to 40 minutes.
30 to 40 minutes. Okay, I think then I can show you that how a basic thing is going on. Okay, so maybe I am going. Let me show you the before going to theory. Let's do some live examples. Okay. Okay, I can write in chat box now. I need to share one link with them.
Yeah, you can share it on YouTube.
Wait a minute. Harsha, actually, I have sent to you that link. Just share that.
Okay, I'll share that.
Okay, which screen? My browser screen visible to you all?
Yes, it is.
Just open this link and just click here, allow. Okay. My actually webcam is with Microsoft. Everyone got the link? So just play with this link. Okay, just go to face expression recognition. Okay, so what is happening? It is analyzing. Just take this example. This is one of the JavaScript. This is not written in Python. First, let me make you clear, because it is a browser based, so it is working in JavaScript. If someone is doing web development, don't think that you are making just HTML pages and web development only. Using JavaScript also, you can make this thing possible. So this is one of the famous repo which one of my mentor has made. Okay, he is a very great person. And okay, so this is one of the GitHub repository which we have made. I am not a that much contributor, but somewhere we did it. So you can see this is the particular phase detector. Okay, so these are the different models and weights. Okay, weights, I will come to you, you know, that what are those weights and all thing. Okay, so just see this thing. Are you guys with this model? Are you guys playing with it? This is a particular face expression recognition. Like, source code is available with us. You can also make it in your local system also. Okay, just you can go to this GitHub link. It is source code is available with this. If you are doing JavaScript or web development, okay. Yeah, JavaScript, there is very JavaScript face API and everything going on. So this is working with you all. Code is working on every system. Just write yes or no if someone is facing problem. Just go to this log button and click allow. Turn off your video. Yeah, okay. So just see this thing. This is the beauty that you are. I told you about the end product. You are not going to make a local system. So every YouTube tutorial you will see on net, the things they will teach you in course, that will be only run in your local system. You cannot, like, there is still a stage of one year practice with you that you can give your fully developed software. Just take the link and run my model. So still there is a phase in, you need to learn the managing. So this is the only in first year only, or you can do it in a training of you can have a 50% knowledge of this thing in your in 2 or 3 months only. Okay, So these are the different things. Like this is just to motivate you guys. Like this, you can do wonders. Okay. So this is the end product. Now, currently, what you will start with some kind of Coursera or Udemy course or your college course. Everything you will run on your local system using OpenCV Python. But the deployment, as I told you about, this is what? This is deployed thing. Okay. Deployed means the particular to end user. Now, I have shared you the link and you guys are using it. So just have a motivation and try to be on that level so that you can make this thing for end user. Okay. Okay, so these are the different things. Okay, now let's directly jump on to the presentation. Is my presentation visible?
Yes, it is visible.
They are delaying live. Yeah. So, okay. So this is the particular thing I need to just take example. That is a very simple thing I want to make you clear. Okay. So just take this as a simple box. This is a simple unit I want to show you. This is just a simple unit, okay. So what I am doing, these are my training parameters. So I told you about I have prepared the data. I have taken my 100 images and I have these are my particular image. What is this? For example, this is my image. Then image is nothing about the pixel values. So you see about image is a matrix. So we are passing the particular matrix. So these are X1. Okay, just take an example. Actually, there is a big theory behind that. Just take an example as X2, X3. Okay, so these are my different features. This is clear to you that my image is nothing. That is just a pixel. Okay, so what is happening here is just like X1, X2, X3. These are particular parameters. So this is one of my neural. This is just my neuron. Okay, just take just called it as a neurate. You call it as a circle, anything. When you will learn the thing, then definitely you are going to get the terms. Okay, just take it as a neuron. Okay, so what I just grab this equation, 11-12th equation. Okay, if this is my W. Okay, so I told you about Y is equal to M X plus C. Okay, just omit this C from here. Y is equal to mx plus, okay, mx. Y is equal to mx. Okay. So what my m is here? M is my w. Just focus here. Okay. What is my m is w? X is my pixel values. M is my w. And I am multiplying these both things. Okay. After the multiplying, I have written here one condition. You see, this is a basic condition of 11-12th class. Okay. The basic equation which we used to do. If it is greater than 0, give the output 1. If it is less than 0, give the output 0. So this is the basic training of a particular model. Most simplest training. Okay. Have you guys got this? Is it clear? Yeah. Okay. So yeah. Thank you, Akash. So just simple thing. Okay. If my value is greater than 0, give the output 1. If my value is less than 0, give the output 0. Okay. So this is the basic thing which I need to teach you. Okay. So these are the weights. These are the training. Side by side, I am teaching my model. These W's are changing. Okay. So what I was told you, like you see there is a, like that in there in phase detection code I showed you, there is one sidebar. That as SSD, you can change the weights, like you can change the weight values here. Okay. So these are the particular machine learning and deep learning. Okay. So I told you, I just told you about the neurons and weights. This is already covered. Okay. So like deep learning also will tell you about the what is the color of the car, what is the maker of the car, what is the color, like, and machine learning, because deep learning is like a more accurate thing because it comes after machine learning. So it's like you can see it as a subset of machine learning. Okay, so red color, Mustang, not car, these are the different parameters which a deep learning model can tell you, and these are the basic thing which a machine learning model can tell you. Okay, so I have already show you the how was this repository to you? It was it good? Like I want to give you some live example. ओके जस्ट शेयर इट विद योर फैमिली एंड फ्रेंड्स आल्सो ओके इट विल वर्क इन एवरी कंप्यूटर ओके नॉट इन फोन्स ठीक है सो नाउ लेट्स कम टू सम करियर पार्ट दैट हाउ टू बिकम अ मशीन लर्निंग मॉडल और मशीन लर्निंग पर्सन ओके basic this was the basic machine learning mathematics I need to tell you and one more thing which we will like there is some zero and one output like I will also tell you about how to make a neural network train okay this is very simple slide very basic thing I will occupy okay okay now let me tell you just focus on this slide very carefully okay this is one of the parameter which was shared by Amazon okay so just focus here so there are if you want to be a future ml scientist so you guys are in first year so you have having a very good advantage I hope so I am not going so fast yes harsh okay harsh and
Pooja. No, it's okay
okay yeah so currently everything is good is everything is having doubt because this is one of the important slide I am going to share so if someone is having problem and kuch samajh mein nahi aaya if someone is having doubt you can write in the live chat because this is one of the important slide I want to share with you yeah okay great youtube channels are here and are you enjoying the session like if everything is going good okay yeah. Yeah you are having a very great names on youtube I can see yeah, that's good okay so this is one of the so how many things you want to pursue your career till now like how many want to you pursue your career in AIML how many of you are thinking for AIML okay only one person okay, no problem okay so now let me tell you yeah you can in your major projects yes okay so now let me tell you that how to like what are the domains and what are the different future aspects you can become after 4 years of training like 4 years of pursuing AIML part like you are having specialization in your college of AIML Harsh
yes we have
okay so how many of you are from AIML part core branch in my audience in from AIML only specialization those who are doing in AIML specialization okay only one okay so those who are doing specialization in a very good first of all let me okay data science branch here okay that's great data science you are having a separate branch for data science okay so before coming to there I must say that your college is very good and you are very lucky that you are having a specialized training and courses of AIML and data science like if you go in IIT and NITs na they are not having specialized courses like if I want to pursue my career in AIML because I need to start from scratch and I need to learn everything from myself I need to do a specialization only for to be in a AIML so yeah that is a very good thing that like just grab that those things that you will learn in your second year I think specialization subjects start from second year only so so just those who are in AIML you are very lucky and just never like it's a very economical branch and the pay of research in this AI branch is really high okay the average salary of a computer software engineer versus AIML engineer AIML is always up in terms of salary if I talk to you okay so those who are from data science and software engineer let me make you one thing clear okay like there are the four different careers of AIML in our computer science field software engineer applied ML engineer core ML engineer and data analyst So these are the, this is the particular metrics you can take a screenshot of, CS fundamentals. So what the happening is, like, there is a very myth that many students ask me that if I want to pursue my career in AI ML, what is the subject I should focus on? Whether my computer fundamentals should be strong, or I should go for the proper probability and probability and static modeling. Whether I need to go for the data modeling and evaluation, like data modeling and evaluation are having different subjects in college. Okay. Whether I should go for probability and statistics, like my probability and math should be high comparing to my coding, or I should focus on the computer engineering subjects like database and all that. Okay. So these are the, like, data analyst and data scientist, somewhere you can correlate these two things. Okay, so these are the particular myths and doubts we always used to have. So this is one of the particular slide for that. If you want to become a software engineer ML, like for example, the software engineer of Google who is preparing a voice assistant for that for end user. If you want to a software engineer of ML, like I am a kind of software engineering ML, I make the end products, then your CS fundamental programming, your DSAs a very must. Don't go for AI without starting for DSA, C++ and basic code languages. Python is already good, but C++, Java, one of the code language, and competitive coding and DSA, these are the parallel things which you need to learn. Without basic DSA and everything, no company will accept you. Even if I share my experience in MNC, this Mirafra Technologies, I have a good AI ML profile, but still 50% of my interview was of data structure and algorithms only. Okay, so CodeChef, CodeForces, if you want I will share those things also, like CodeForces, CodeChef. These are the different website you can perceive, hai na? So these are like data structure and algorithms are very, very must in computer science for getting a job in good MNCs. Okay, so you should take care of that also. Okay, just don't like this go for AI ML and just leave everything. Okay, data structure and AI ML is very data structure and algorithms is very basic thing. Okay, and you should all know that. So what is software, what we do in software engineering ML? My CS fundamental programming, my data structure and competitive coding. How many of you heard about competitive coding? Okay, competitive coding. How many of you heard about competitive coding, data structure and algorithms? Okay, yeah. So data structure and algorithms, like do practice on CodeChef, CodeForces, LeetCode, Geek for Geeks. These are the very, very good sites. So your these things should be very much pretty much clear to you. Okay. Software engineering and all that. Like, so if you are want to perceive like a software engineer, if you are going for data structure and algorithm, then you can compromise with the probability and statistics. Okay, data modeling and standard life, but your system designing and software engineering, like your database software engineering subject, that will come in further years to you. That is very important if you want to go for a software engineer ML. If you want to applied ML engineer, then your applying ML model and algo should be very clear. Just search these terms later on the net. If you want to being an applied ML engineer, then you for go for these two things. These two things should be strong. This PPT, this slide I have shared, because these things are the, if you are going for a, like for a job description, it is written, Google is hiring an applied ML engineer. Then the most of the interview question will be from these two aspects, like your applying ML model and algorithms should be good. So software engineer, what software he need not to care about the applying ML. ML algorithm and libraries, that will be done by the applied ML engineer. Only work of the software ML engineer is he need to apply that. Okay, basic designing is done by the applied ML engineer. After that, core ML engineer, this is a bit high profile and bit senior positions are on, like Google always take the PhD people for like core ML things. Okay, so for that you see CS fundamental, probability and stat, data modeling and evaluation, applying ML, these, like you see, you need to work much harder for this core ML. After that, data analyst and data science. Okay, so for these two things, your probability and data modeling and evaluation should be very good. Okay, your probability and stats match should be very good if you want to go for data analyst and business analyst tech analyst. Okay, in AI ML, if you want to go for that, then your probability and data modeling bot modeling should be very good. Okay, so these are the things which you should know in the first year only. So we always live in a like a big fog that we don't know that what to do, that how to do the thing. So I will share the content also, how you, if you don't know Python also, I will tell you that how you can Python for data science and all that. I will share some courses. So this is the basic roadmap of machine learning, that how to become a machine learning expert. So first you need to understand the basics, that what are my basics. Basic here comes also the data structure and algorithms also. You need to grab that also. After that, learn about the statistics, select your language, learn basic and learn statistics, select your language like Python or R. R, you may have heard about R, like whether most of we go for Python because there are so many tutorials available. Okay, explorability analysis of the project, create unsupervised models. Analysis of the project here means just analyze which are the what is your aim, what is the further aim. Okay, so creating unsupervised models, train your models. Okay, create supervised models. Okay. So these are the basic things how to become a machine learning expert. So learn about supervised model, unsupervised model, understanding the big data technologies. So these are the topics covered. I have written in this subheading. Okay, explore deep learning models and undertake the complete data project. So these are the particular things you need to learn before particular pathway I am sharing. Just take a screenshot of this. I will share the PPT later on with her. She will share to you. Okay, so these are the particular roadmap which this is a very verified roadmap. Okay, like first year mein every you heard about that these guys are very famous code with Haryana Mand Atarwal and these guys, everyone share these kinds of steps only. Okay, so these are the particular steps. Just watch those videos and take advice from everywhere. Okay, so these are the machine learning engineer path. Maths core concepts should be clear. Programming language, learn about that database, machine learning libraries, deep learning, big data visualization tools. Then you will become an expert. Okay, these are the particular machine learning engineer path. Okay, so these are the different ML tools and libraries. I want to make like TensorFlow. In future, you will repeatedly heard about TensorFlow, scikit-learn. And how many heard about scikit-learn, PyTorch, TensorFlow, SkyPy, Scilab, R, NLP? Have you heard about these libraries? Okay, yeah, that's great. So these are the different libraries which you will know. Just take note of those names and learn about these things. But before DSA and DSA and basic stats and basic coding language is must. Okay. So what is AI? AI is ML with PyTorch. You can do ML with PyTorch, deep learning with TensorFlow, deep learning scikit-learn. Okay, deploying ML models, like deploying ML models. How many heard about AWS? I have heard about this. One of the partner of this event is AWS. So we deploy the models on AWS. Okay, AWS is for deploying the models. So we always use in my company. I always use Amazon Web Services for deploying the ML models for the end user. Okay. So AI with computer vision. So these are the various aspects. Hai na, Python data processing hoti hai Python mein. After that, AI with Python. Python is a very trending language in AI nowadays. Okay. So these are the particular courses. These are the particular books. And repositories I have shared. Just take the link of that. I have shared the link. So let me just open these. Let me show you just these notebooks. Okay. So this is the particular artificial intelligence, which is a very famous repository. Okay, so these are the particular courses, MIT courses and various courses, combination of edX, Coursera courses, which you can try on with. Okay, just take that which is the most suitable course for you. Okay, these are the particular books which you can buy, which you can like PDF of those books I have compiled. Okay, these are the particular books you can use. Okay, so first and Coursera courses, you just read the books, read from the basic. You all guys are coming from 12th class and all that, na? So you just imagine that till 10th and class you are reading from the books only. So the knowledge which books give you, na, these things are not that much clear by the online courses only. Okay, so these are the particular things. Okay, like philosophy, like there is a very good content in this code, na? Tutorial on deep learning, like it's a very just combination of everything. Just read the research papers also. I will come to that part, research and industry also. Okay, so this is one of the thing I have shared, and this is the link. Second link is for the books. Okay, these are the different books. Book PDF content is there. That is shared in the slide. Okay, so just take note of these things. Okay. And just read the books. I must say that I always read the books and take notes. Okay. See. Okay. Now let's go. Okay. How to start with? Yeah. How to get? Okay. Yeah. That is complete. So these are the particular contents I want to share with you. Okay, so now next thing is this is a particular meme. Just see that when you ever to learn to try deep learning, that linear algebra, calculus, not enough GPU, complex papers. Okay, so just don't think that machine learning is a very fancy term and you will learn about everything in short. Okay, just take care of example like do learn about linear algebra. Okay, these are the different problems we face. Learn about calculus, like, yeah, I know integral calculus was a tough part in 11, 12, but these things keep a good aspect in machine learning. Even it will build your logics only. It will make your brain sharp. And if you are striving for Microsoft, Google, if you want to go for product level companies, big fan companies, then these knowledge of these things, it will not only help in your artificial intelligence, but it will also make in your data structure and algorithms only, okay? So these things matter in big companies, okay? So not enough GPU, like you are having, if you're not, some people give up, like I am not having much powerful computer. So don't think, I will show you Google Colab also. So, okay, so that was, that. This is one of the next meme, like 10 year, what is changed? People, the same thing which in 2009, we used to like y is equal to mx plus c, same thing machine learning, same thing we are calling it as machine learning. So not that much complete, only the perceivance is changed. Okay, the things are same, only our perspective to see the things are changing. Okay, so okay, next meme I want to share, like these are the different things, like machine learning. What is machine learning? Is all about stats. Okay, just keep the photo of machine learning after the artificial intelligence. So many people will come to you, okay? But basic thing is maths, okay? Now next is never do this thing, like this boy is going, like these are the different things which you will got to know on Instagram. Wait. So these are the different things. Okay, never go for directly for AIML. Learn about basic operating object oriented programming, data structure, algorithms, AIML and all that. Okay, so how to practice with AI, how to make yourself in different, participate in AI hackathons, like on Devfolio, and there are so many hackathons are organized by Indian Innovation Council, like MHRD, AICT, my government, and like this event is also IAC is one of the partners. So we always take part of these government competition and Devfolio. Like it will give you a much higher knowledge. Okay, take part in hackathons, make projects, do computer programming and all that. So these are some of my hackathons which are as a part of Smart India hackathon is done by. Okay, so these are the particular hackathons I participated in Smart India hackathon. If you guys, you can connect me on LinkedIn. Okay, so Lost Vote Challenge was one of the hackathon which was conducted by Times of India, GitHub and IBM. And I presented my solution to election commission chief. So he was the one of the evaluators. So like it will be a good source of income. Like you will earn lot of these from these kinds of hackathons. Like you see, Smart India hackathon prize is 1.5 lakhs. Okay, lost good talent was around 2.5 lakhs. Okay, IICDC, this was one of the competition which IIM Bangalore, it will help you grow in the company. So like everything, these kinds of competition are held by the Ministry of Government and Indian Innovation Council. Like everything, every year these kinds of do take part. It will really appreciate and it will make you clear very things. Okay. So these are the different things. Okay, these are some of my projects. Like this is a brain control wheelchair. I will share these things later on as we are running out of time. Okay, so I just give me 5 minutes more. Okay, Harsh. So these are the different projects I have made. This is a brain control wheelchair. Okay, so it will just think about, just if you will think about going left, it will move left. Okay, this is the one of the particular wheelchair I have made it in my college. So this is one of the model appreciated by DRDO also. So DRDO sponsored this project, and this is one of the Drishti project, and this is currently this project is currently going on under IIM Bangalore support. So the IIM Bangalore is providing funds and support to us for this Drishti project. So you see, this is one of my quadbot. You can go to my LinkedIn profile. I have uploaded the videos also of this. So this is like a quadbot. Like you see, it's a defense thing. Like it is a kind of IoT based. So Drishti is like kind of project. I can control your movements from anywhere. I will give you one device and it will automatically turn your leg whenever some obstacle will come in between. So it will automatically, like you just search for the TEDx videos of controlling another human. So it's just like I'm controlling your hands and legs. So hey, using this project, I can control your hands also using electrical muscle simulation. Okay. Like do industrial or research internships. Okay, industrial and research internships are like you are having a very good faculty in your college. Just approach them and tell them, sir or ma'am, I want to write a research paper in AIML. They are having this lot of topics and all that. Okay, so just approach them and tell them, I want to write a research paper, publish a research paper, go search for Scopus Index. Okay. IEEE link. Okay, these are the different things. Like just focus that after 4 years where you want to be. If you want to if you want to be a particular job like person, you want to go in a corporate sector. Okay, let me tell you, for industrial internship, these two parameters, LinkedIn and AngelList. If you want to be a corporate guy, then search the internships on LinkedIn and AngelList. These don't go for Internshala. Internshala is not that much good. They are having fake everything. Most of the internships are fake there. So AngelList and LinkedIn, search for the AIML, make your CV. Okay, if you want to go for a corporate life. Okay, and if you want to pursue PhD or master or thesis, go for Gmail here means make a cover letter. Yeah, write some research paper with your college, make a cover letter and write the professors, write the mail to the good PhD professor in foreign countries like Finland, France, Germany have a research scholarships. Okay, so using Gmail, find the list of those professors. Currently I'm running out of time, but I would have told you about each and everything, how you can cover your cover letter. That is a separate session we can take on. Like how to make a cover letter, how to go for research internships in foreign colleges like Finland College, Germany College, Germany, Bonn, France. Like these are the various different colleges which invite in the students from India. You mail them, like, sir, I am from NIIT. I have did this project. This is the paper which I have written under my this teacher. Okay. So I written under my this teacher and just mail them. They will invite you and they will sponsor you. Okay, like I got the internship from one of the Alto University of Eastern Felden. You know, in my but due to COVID times, I was unable to go there. Okay, so do research internships. Just make, you want to go for PhD, go for research internships. Like write research papers. Okay, and if you want to go for search the post on internships on LinkedIn and AngelList. Okay, so this is the one of the particular perceptron which I was thinking to make. Like this is a very basic, but I think we are running out of time. So let me just directly share you one Collab notebook. Okay. Harsh, this is one of the hands-on. If you are having 5 minutes, just tell me that if you are having time or not. Harsh or Purnima, are you there?
Yeah, actually I was thinking we can arrange another session for that.
Another session? Okay, let me show them this final training model, okay? So this is the one of the is my screen visible? Yeah. So these are the particular collab notebook for the face detection. I think we are running out of time. So this is one of the very basic thing I should have conveyed this to you with the theory also. So just run this collab notebook. It will take your photo. It will detect your face in that. Okay. So this is the particular face my face is detected. So this is the particular using OpenCV I have made this. Okay. So it is a more around 10 to 15 minutes tutorial. So I think we should go for ask AMA sessions also. Okay. So that's why I am just sharing this link with you all. So I am just sharing this link with you. So just if something is not clear, to just you can contact me on my LinkedIn. Okay. So this is the particular project, small project, which we may have completed, but we are running out of time. We can try it somewhere, or you can go for some tutorials also. Okay. I think here we done. If the time is so okay. This is that was a normal face detection. So this is a basic perceptron algorithm, which I can tell you that this is a very basic thing. Let me just share with you. That is a very basic thing. Just for example, this is my X1 is my input light. This is the particular example that how a machine learning or artificial intelligence get trained. Just take it as a one. Okay, I will take just 2 minutes more. For example, if my X1 is one and I want to train a model which will give my output zero. Okay. So what will happen here is this is a particular terms like W I have already here. Y is equal to mx plus c, m is m here is W. Okay, I will write a function which will give my x1 into W1, which is 1. Okay, so let's take for the initial part, let me take W1 is equal to 1 and my input is x1 is equal to 1, but my actual output should be 0. Okay, so if I multiply x1 with W1, what will be my output? Just write in the chat box. What will be my output if I will write x1 into W1? Obviously 1. Okay. But what my model should give, like this, that was a training. Someone was asking how to make the model evaluate. My evaluation is that my model should give predicting which is 1. Or what is now, after that we analyze what is the error. Error is of 1. Error should be 0, actual should be 0, but I am getting -1. Okay. So what is the error? Error is -1. Okay. So error here is -1. Okay. So what I will do is I will update the M. M here is my W, my weights. I will update my weights. So what will be my new weight? W1 is equal to 1 plus error. Okay. This is the simplest equation you will found in the perceptron algorithm. Okay. You will learn about this perceptron algorithm. It's the most basic neural network you will make. Okay. Just multiply this. My new W1 is 0. Okay. So you see, this is the simplest equation which is already tuned the W according to the actual outputs. Basic simple maths application. Okay. So this is the particular output, and finally I got my output as 0. Okay. So same thing happens in Google Collab also. Okay. So my actual predicted output should be 1, but my actual output was 0, but predicted was 1. So what that is, I updated the weights. Okay. So this is a very basic thing. You can, I have made this slide like this, like you can learn this on your own. Okay. So that's all from my side. And wait, just one more thing is, okay. So just deploy after that, after making, like you can deploy models on AWS, Jupyter Notebook, CI/CD pipeline. These are different modules you can use. Like there are the ethics in AI, where the while making an AI model, what are the ethics you should use. You may have seen the movie iRobot, where they have used the seven fundamental rules of making robot. Okay. Always trust the machine as well as well-trained humans. Okay. So so this is my LinkedIn ID and GitHub. You can reach out to me on my LinkedIn ID. So that's all from my side. Okay, thanks a lot for your time, guys.
Thank you, Rishabh, so much. It was really a very nice session. We had a lot to take away. The links and references were really nice. And thank you everyone for joining. Hope you guys enjoyed. And we have shared a feedback form on YouTube. You guys can check it and fill it. And thank you once again, Rishabh. We'll surely have one more session with you. It was very interesting.
No problem. If anyone is having any questions right now, or we are ending up the thing?
I think we are running short of time. Okay.
Thank you, Rishabh. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Rishabh.
Thank you for your time. It was wonderful having you here, and we'll have another session for sure.
Yeah, yes, ma'am. Thanks a lot.